नहीं
थोड़ा एक मिनट थोड़ा आगे हो जाओ थोड़ा सा। So the online shopper in you must be intrigued about how a package gets to you from the seller. Well, I'm here in Haryana at Amazon's fulfillment center, and I'm going to show you how a package comes from point A to your doorstep. First, you got to have something to sell, right? Each product comes with a barcode and they are assembled on things called pallets. Each product is matched with a pallet, and that's how the workers keep a track of which product is where. So where I'm standing right now, it's called the receive station, where the products are categorically brought in from the pallets, which are spread across according to how the sellers send them. So here, the products go through a quality check, and then they're taken forward into the next area. We'll get to the packages in a bit. First, check out how the employees start their day. Okay, so this is a routine exercise that all employees have to go through before starting their shift. It's good, man. It's exercise. I like it. Boy, that was intense. Back to the process now. After the security check, the packages are again slotted for storage in multiple levels spread across the facility, while bigger products are stacked in large six-story shelves like these. So after the process of quality checking is done, the products are then placed in a basket and brought to this storage area, where they are placed not by category or by brand, but by what size they come in. Interesting. So, in a way, a bottle of shampoo could be placed with a motorcycle clutch. This is something Amazon finds more convenient. When an order is placed, the associates track down the ordered products in these aisles and then send them for packaging in baskets like these. So, after the product is picked up from the shelf, it's then placed on a conveyor belt by the associate, which comes here. This is the packaging station where, as you can see, this is how it's packaged. And then the associate puts it on the same conveyor belt, which then goes to the next stage. While packaging, the computer tells the associate what kind of package is meant for each product. However, there are times when the packaging might not be as expected, and this is why.
We have about 170 million products on the website, right? There are algorithms which are always designed to identify for a particular size of a shipment what should be the ideal packaging. Where item is looked at as a dimension, we look at the dimension of the item. If that process, for example, there is a defect in that process, which is a very rare occurrence, but it could, then the dimension of the product would be shown differently in a system. And then actually when you are packing it, it will give a box size of that dimension.
Later, the packed items are sorted by executives based on standard or express delivery region-wise. Then, all these products are stacked at the dock to be loaded for delivery. So this is the final stage of the whole process, and where a package is finally put into trucks and transported to different parts of the country.
It depends upon where the customer is and where the inventory is, right? So if the sellers are, let's say, it's a Delhi-based seller or a Gurgaon-based seller, and the customer is in Delhi or Gurgaon, then you could get the shipment the same day or the next day, right? Based on location, it will change.
So the next time I order something online, this whole process will run through my mind again. And if there are any delays, I'll have a better idea of what could have gone wrong.